Hi, this is Sally. 2 weeks ago, I left you with a question. How clean is your food? Right? So today I'm going to talk about that. And I'm going to look at it in three areas. The first is water. The second is on labels. And the third is on the meat that we eat. So let's talk about water first. So most of the time, right, we would think that potable water is totally fine. But what potable water means is that it's drinkable. You know, when you drink it, nothing will happen. But that doesn't mean that it's free from contaminants. So most of the time, you will hear advertisements talking about buying a filter or buying a water purifier, right? Okay, and the reason is because this water, although it's potable, is transported from the reservoir into our homes through the pipes. And these pipes, if you can imagine, are decades years old, or it could be 30, 40, 50 years old. And most of the pipes are made of metal. And sometimes the metal would rust, right? And furthermore, contaminants could actually seep into the pipe into the water. So in my company, we actually did we did talks we do talks and part of the talk includes water testing. So most of the time we ask our audience to bring water from their home. And it's quite interesting because different locations around Singapore have different levels of contaminants. So for example, like in Jurong, which is a more industrial area, the water contaminants that we tested are actually higher. Some places have more plastic. So that's something to take note. I think next time I'll make a video on filters and water purifiers and to tell you what's the difference and what to look out for if you're considering buying a water purifier. But just to take note, when you're talking about potable water, yes, it's drinkable, but it doesn't kill you at the moment, but it doesn't mean that it's healthy because the accumulated toxins and undigestible elements, for example, like plastic, we found plastic inside, or insoluble minerals. So when we talk about iron, it's not the kind of iron we find in vegetables, right? So things like that. Your body cannot digest it if it's not passed out, it remains somewhere within. So that's the first element, which is water. The next thing is we talk about labels, because when we go to the supermarket, right, and we want to eat healthy, we rely a lot on labels. So and mo the, of course the most popular label is organic. So there are three things to take note actually when you're looking at labels. So when you look at labels and it's labeled organic, it doesn't mean that it's 100% organic. So all products are allowed the label organic as long as it's 95% organic. So that 5% is purely chemicals and any kind of deadly chemicals or whatever, right? It is still labeled organic as long as it's 95% organic. So organic products doesn't mean that it's really organic. Except for products that are labeled 100% organic. So that's organic. Another thing to take note is there's another type of labeling called made with organic ingredients. And these labels are usually found in processed foods, right? So processed foods, and they say made with organic ingredients. So made with organic ingredients simply means that at least 70% of the product is made from organic ingredients. Just 70%, at least 70%. It can be higher, but it can be as low as 70%. Okay, and finally, the last thing I want to talk about is meat. So I'm sure you heard talk about, how a healthy meat can be. A lot of us like to eat meat, right? So there are two things to take note. I think nowadays, when we talk about meat, there's a lot of hormones injected into the meat. This is because it's factory farming, it's a profit-making industry. They want the chicks to grow up as soon as possible in order so that, they can sell off and be slaughtered and be fat and juicy for us to eat, right? So you have all these chickens being pumped out with hormones. And it's not just chickens, the cows as well. So they're pumped out with hormones to accelerate their growth. So they grow bigger, faster, and then they be slaughtered as meat. Yes, so these hormones are then, you know, we eat this meat and it's we take this into our body, and quite what's the repercussions? Sometimes hormonal imbalance, it's because of eating meat, simply because there's too much hormones injected into the meat these days, right? And the other thing that is ancillary to it is, you know, as Asians, we love to drink soup, and part of brewing the soup is brewing the pork and brewing the chicken inside for hours, right? So as far as possible, you know, I would not drink soup stewed with meat, not very often, although I love soup. Yeah, so that's one. The second thing is also, it's also, you know, at the point of slaughter. At the point of slaughter, the animals are actually aware of what's happening. I don't know whether you have seen videos on factory farming or in the slaughterhouses. The animals are terrified, are totally terrified, and some of them are screaming, right? So at the point of slaughter, when that happens, and when you're talking about animals that are highly intelligent, like cows, like pigs, right? They know what's going on, so they undergo incredible stress at the point of time. So at that point of time, there's a lot of, you know, when we have a lot of stress, there's a lot of toxins being produced. Yeah, so the hours or the minutes up to the slaughter, and at the point of slaughter itself, lots of toxins is produced by these animals and released into the bloodstream, or, you know, and you know, and then we take the meat, right? And then we stew it for hours in a soup, and then we just consume it. So just for that reason, right? If you look at our diet, it's very hard. It's almost impossible to eat totally clean. And that's why, you know, I feel that an essential part of keeping healthy is to do detoxification daily, actually, to remove as much toxins as possible that is consumed, because we cannot totally avoid them. Yeah, so how clean is your food today? I would say not really. And the measures that we take, right, are insufficient, and it's very difficult to eat totally clean these days. So I hope you find my sharing useful. I'll share some solutions, especially in terms of water. I think that's really important. And of course, the solution would be more of plan B, because since you can't really control totally what is coming in, you try to remove as much as possible through detoxification. I hope you found this video useful, and I'll see you in the next video.